Yeah, good morning, students. Yeah, before starting today's class, I want to clarify one thing about giving the presentations. So often I'm getting that complaint that you're not getting how to give the presentation, right? Because whenever I give the presentation, I need to explain new people so that you'll understand. Okay, so while giving the presentation, actually we don't speak anything. As I told, only our facial expressions speaks a lot, right? So today, okay, with an example, I'll teach you how to give the presentation. Before that, what are the steps we follow while giving the presentation is more important, okay? So first thing, okay, before children arrive at the school, adults as teachers will be there before the children, right? Any preschool or any Montessori school, because this is pure Montessori method what you are learning, okay? What I am taking all the four subjects, and that is in a pure Montessori method. So here what happens, as soon as the children goes home in the afternoon or else in the morning, as soon you enter your environment, that is not classroom, your environment, first thing is you have to check all the materials, right? So in Pinter, if any one of the cube is missing, then the material is not complete. You can't give presentations to the children with half of the material, okay? So one thing, you have to check the material. Again, lids are open, lids are below the material, means if only binomial, trinomial cube material is closed, okay, we bring along with the lid, because we need that print is there, no? Have you seen that imprint of the material on the lid? So because of that, we are going to bring with the lid only binomial and trinomial. Whatever the other materials, lid will be under the material. You have to open and you have to keep it below, under the material, so the children will understand this material is ready to work. Right? Anything, if one part is missing, you can't give the presentation. That is your duty, adult's duty, to check the materials. Again, broken materials, you can't give. Right? All those things, it's your duty to check. Okay, then, once the children comes to your environment, maybe you are having 10 to 12 children. As I told in Montessori method, we divide the children. It's not like what M1, M2, M3. Pure Montessori, we divide the children, maybe 2.5 to 3.5, 4 children, 4.5 to 5.5, 4 children, 5.5 to 6, 6.5, 4 children with you. So you need to know which are the presentations you have to give today. Okay, already my child has done these many things. So maybe other child has to repeat these many things. A new presentation, what and all you have to give. Because you are going to give EPL, sensorial, language and arithmetic, together it goes. It's not like that one will finish EPL, then we'll start sensorial. No. Together, once you start with EPL, then sensorial, then your language, then arithmetic, all together it goes. Maybe child practices all the areas every day. Okay, maybe EPL is doing something in sensorial, maybe he's doing pink talk. Again, it comes to language, is doing some oral activities at the beginning. Just I'm giving you the example. In arithmetic, he is doing the number rods. Again, we have biology, zoology, botany, as I told, many other activities. Art and craft, your rhymes, your stories, everything goes together as like in normal method. Right? So, now, if you want to give any presentation to the child, the first part, as I told, you need to prepare your material before calling the child. Right? So then you give invitation to the child. Okay? The first part of your presentation is invitation. Okay? Before that, you have to prepare your environment that is does not belong to this group. That is everyday's duty. You have to do that. First part of your presentation is invitation. Why are you giving the invitation? No, you are making the child ready to learn something, or else you are respecting the child's emotions. The child feels, yes, my auntie, we call auntie, somewhere they'll call Didi, somewhere they'll call Akka, whatever it is. Okay, in Montessori House of Children, we call auntie, we don't call ma'am or miss, no, okay, auntie or Didi, whatever it is. Okay, so if the child says no, not now, I want to do that. If the child says that time you have to leave the child. Okay, you finish that work, then call me. Okay, that means you are respecting the child's emotions. Yes, the child feels that. He'll be very happy next time. Yes, that time auntie called me, I didn't go, now I have to go. Right? So invitation, short and sweet invitation. Today shall we see how to work with the pink dot, any invitation, as you wish. Right? So after that, the preparation. What is preparation? You are taking the child to the place of display, because all the materials will be displayed according to the child's height and according to the orderness. First EPL begins from 2.5 to 6 years. EPL also, we have a activities from 2.5 to 6 years. So EPL starts from 2.5, it goes orderly till 6 years. Then your sensorial, cinder blocks, pink tar, brown stays, long rods, it goes like that. Okay, maybe in the other room you can arrange arithmetic. In the other room, maybe if you have 4 rooms, you can arrange. Because here we don't have any classroom, the child has to sit in a particular place, nothing like that. Whenever the child is working EPL, let him sit in this room. Whenever he is with the sensorial, let him shift to the another room, language, third room, okay, arithmetic, the other room. Right? So then you take the child to the place of display, introduce the material. Why are we taking the child to the place of display? Because the child should know where it is displayed, because after the presentation, the child has to keep the material back to its place, not anywhere. The child cannot throw or cannot keep the material wherever place is there. All the materials have their own place. Okay? Again, in the preparation, you are going to show the child how to hold and carry the material. Again, in the preparation, already beginning of the EPL, we are given the presentation, how to roll and unroll the mat, how to bring the chowki. Okay, so if you take pink tar, we are going to do it on the working mat, not on chowki. Here I am showing, just I want everyone to see. Okay, almost all the activities we do it on the work mat. So already you are given the presentation, the child knows how to roll and unroll the work mat. In the preparation part, you are going to ask the child, will you bring one work mat and unroll your? The child unrolls the work mat. Then you are going to take the child to the place of display, show him the material, introduce. Maybe the child knows, but it's your duty to introduce once again. Then you are going to bring the material one by one, as it should be. Okay, some materials will bring it all thing, few materials will bring one by one, as it should be. You need to bring the material. You are going to sit, the child is sitting next to you. Till here it's a preparation. Then your presentation. Before the presentation, we are going to give one statement. Shall we see what can we do with this statement? Okay, the first one, you are given the invitation, Okay, then your preparation. Okay, then your statement. In the statement, you are grabbing the attention of the child. Right? See, what can we do with this? Shall we see what can we do with this? Whatever the statement, short statement. It's not like that, see, we have brought the pink towel, so we are going to do something. That, this, don't narrate any story to the child. Simple, short, attractive statement. Right? After the statement, your presentation starts. Right? In presentation part, if it is required to speak anything, you have to speak. If it is not required, please don't speak. Whatever you want to show, only with your facial expressions. That is more important for a preschool teacher or a Montessori teacher. Facial expressions. Okay? Teachers, if children are doing some naughtiness, they're not listening to you, only with your eyes, with your face, you have to make them sit silent. You can't take stick and beat them to make them silent. No. Only your facial expression speaks a lot to the child. The child can make out, yes, today my ma'am is angry. Auntie is angry. Just with your, no. Good. The child is very happy. If you just say with smile, good. Or else, no. That's it. Your voice modulation, your voice. No, it changes every time. That's the quality of teacher. Don't take the stick. No. Right? So, even in presentation, only your facial expression speaks a lot. If it is required, you can speak. Few materials, it is required. Where it is, if you want to ask something, only that much. Right? So, after the presentation, you are going to give the conclusion. That is also part of the presentation. I think while writing the presentation, you have observed, this is the way we do it. Okay? So, beginning we told, shall we see what can we do with this? Again, after the presentation, we are telling, this is the way we do this. Okay? Then you ask the child, shall we do it again? Repeating the presentation. After you present anything, immediately the child has to repeat that. And first time, until he repeats, you should sit along with the child. Once he finishes completely, the next part is winding up. Okay, the last one is winding up. Even the child should know how to keep the materials back. Even the child should understand that after working any material, he has to keep the material back in its place. Not only materials, even the mat. Again, if he wants to do something else on the same work mat, not a problem. After that, he has to roll it and he has to keep that mat also in his place. Got it? So these are the few steps we follow while giving the presentation. Why I am explaining in detail? If they ask in your interview, again, are you giving your own presentations, right? So there also, just whenever you are giving the presentation, maybe you are not children, so I am explaining to the teachers. So even you are going to explain to other people, means you can explain. See, these are the steps we are going to follow in the presentation, and now I will start giving the presentation. Okay, now you already know pink tar, so I will give you the presentation of pink tar. I need one child. Any one of you, please, first. I'll call you afterwards, okay? You can sit here, I'll call you. Yes, because you people can understand better. Yeah? So, here is my child. Yeah, now I'm not going to speak anything. I'm not going to explain you anything because already you know the presentation of Pinter. Okay? Yeah. Today, shall we see how to work with the Pinter? Yes. So, will you unroll a work mat here? Just think she has unrolled it. Yeah? Come. Okay? This is Pinter. Okay? See, this is the way we carry Pinter. Will you carry? Shall we see what can we do with this? See, this is the way we build the Pinter. Okay, see how it is looking? It is looking same as it was there. Right? Shall we do it again? Yes. Now we'll take out. Will you take out? Do it. Is it correct? Yes. Do you want to repeat once again? Yes. So if the child says yes, okay, this is till here it's a presentation. If the child says yes, allow the child. Okay, just you can move from here, because once you have seen the child's activity, she is doing good. Okay. Again, if the child says no, it's enough, then you have to teach the child how to keep it back. So shall we keep this back? Okay. Then you ask the child to keep everything down. Again, she has to start from the big one. Yeah. Yeah, I'll come to that. Okay. I'll clarify this. Okay. Understood now how to give the presentation? Okay. Did I speak in between? Only my facial expression. So again, everything, if you do wrong also, okay, purposefully we are doing wrong. Okay. Yes. Only that much. Okay. No. Yes. The child understands, because material itself shows the result. Okay. The child understands. No, auntie, it's wrong. Yes. Okay. Keep it back. Again, do it. Understood now how to give the presentation? Whatever the presentation, you have to give like this. That's why I'm telling you, people, practice in this manner. It's not like that, this is the material, this is how the we work. No. Okay, material you can understand, but giving the presentation is more important. Right? Even in your examination, you have to give presentations like this only. Right from the invitation. It's not like that, you'll bring the material here, you'll show something, or else you're giving the presentation only, you'll explain so many things to the child. No. Whoever it is, you need to practice. You just think, I'm just thinking, she's my child. Whoever it is, I don't know, now so many schools are coming here to take the interviews. Maybe next time you may go to their school to give the presentations. They may ask you. Right? You just think, practice is more important. So that's why in the session itself, last time I told. So this time also, you need to practice like this. At least one presentation, if you practice every day, that will be better. Understood, no? Yeah. Again, thank you. Yeah. Her doubt was when to give the name lessons, okay? After the child has sufficiently worked with Pinktar, all the exercises, you know, two exercises are there. Again, memory exercises. After all the exercises, you can give the name lessons, big and small. After some time, when the child is around four and a half years, that time you can give the superlative and comparative degrees of this one, right? Any doubts in giving the presentation? Yeah, while giving the presentation, if you want to explain, as I explained, these are the steps I'm going to follow while giving the presentation. Before, while giving the presentation, don't explain anything. Right? No doubts? Got it? Yeah. So, afternoon session, okay, from the beginning, at least I need four presentations. Okay, we have very less time and almost we have covered everything. Okay, only few are left out. So from here onwards, maybe today, maybe the last class, or day of next class, maybe we'll do. So after that, whatever the classes we give, only the practice session. You need to practice. Yeah, that is more important. As a Montessorians, as a Montessori adults, if he doesn't know how to give the presentation, then it is the use of learning the whole year. Yeah. Any doubts? If you have any doubts, you can clarify and then we'll move to the next one. I don't want you people to keep any doubts in your mind regarding any material or any area we are following. No doubts.
education, definitely so then this is for if not in House of Children, now
this is how we are going to give the presentation. Just the child will come to know you are searching for the big one.
If they ask, then
who will ask?
Examiner, I think when we demo. Only demo itself.
They may ask you some questions. See, my experience when I gave my exam, one adult only, not adult also, there are lecturers, directors. Okay, so they used to act as a child. Okay, now my child was so good, she didn't say anything. But the examiners, they used to act like they are a small children, they doesn't know anything. They used to do so many mistakes. All those things they'll do. Okay, that time you can explain. Okay, if the child, no, I didn't get your question. If the examiner asks you what is big, what is small. Only the presentation. Okay, so it depends. Name lessons, if they give presentation of Pinter, only this much. If they ask presentation of Pinter and name lessons, you need to, after the presentation, if in your question if it is there, or else if the examiner asks what else you can do with this, you can, right? So you, before that only, that's why before that only you just clarify while giving the presentation tomorrow or whatever. This presentation you can, okay, this presentation you can, okay, but whatever you give like this, okay, because here your topic is only Pinter, so you are going to give all the possible presentations, possible activities with the Pinter, okay, that I'll agree, but you don't, yeah. Understood? So here you can see, see, we can give, teach name lessons, big and small also with this. Again, memory game. Yeah, you can. You have to. Okay, you have to explain the whole part. What and all we can do with this Pinter. Right? Yeah, any doubts? Last class? No doubts? So shall we move on to the next one? Yeah, in sensorial we have some more, so that we'll finish it off today, right? So now the next presentation is Baric tablets. Baric tablets. What is Baric sense? BARIC, Baric. Sense, what is that sense? Sense of? Sense of weight. Sense of weight. Baric sense, BARIC. Baric sense. Again, here we have a material called Baric tablets. See, your material should be like this. Lid below, like this. In your House of Children, all the materials will be like this. Okay? Again, while going home, you just close everything, dust it, close it, and go. Again, tomorrow morning, as soon you enter your environment, open and keep it. Okay, so here we have a Baric tablets. Okay, three sets. Can you all see the material? So here we have in one box three sets, sometimes three separate boxes. Don't be confused. I'm telling you all the possibilities. Here we have all the three sets in one box. Sometimes you'll get three different boxes. Yeah, I will keep it down. So here we have three sets. Okay, can you see the color differentiation? Okay, all the three sets are different colors, maybe light to dark. Okay, this is darker. Okay, again dark, darker, darkest. We have three. Okay, so the first one with the light white. The first, okay, here in each set we have a 7, okay, wooden cutouts, right? In each set we have, this is light one, this is medium, this you are not going to explain to the child, light, medium and all. Okay, just right, lightweight, medium, heavy. Okay, so all the 7 tablets in each group of same size, same weight and same color. Don't be confused. Okay, one set light white, so all the 7 tablets are of same color, same weight and same size. Okay, again when it comes to medium, okay, again it is heavy. Okay, light, medium, heavy. You can note down like this: light, medium, heavy. Yeah, over. So I'm explaining little slowly, okay, so that better you understand the material. Montessori thing, you need to understand the material. That's it. Okay, now presentation. While giving the presentation, give invitation. Today shall we work with new material? Yes. Okay, take the child to the place of display. Introduce the material. Okay, this is Barrick tablet box. Or is these three are Barrick tablet boxes. If you have three boxes. Okay, now the child has to carry only two sets of materials to the place of presentation. Here we are going to use only two sets. Okay, better while giving the presentation, we are taking light and heavy. Light, heavy. As the child to carry it to the place of presentation. Okay, now shall we see what can we do with this? Okay, now as the child to stretch his palm, okay, her hand, okay, this is the way we take the impression of weight. Okay, see, you have to keep on your palm, okay, in between your fingers and your palm. Okay, again you need to see up and down, do up and down. Okay, this is how we take the impression of weight. Yeah, then as the child to stretch another hand. Okay, this is the way we take the impression with both the hands. Same. Here we are just showing the child how to take the impression of weight. Okay. Now, I want any one as a child first. Okay, so now you'll get one blindfold. Okay, along with this material. Okay, now I'll just ask the child to close her eyes. Okay, she not open your eyes. Okay, close your eyes. Okay, stretch your hand. Okay, take the impression. Another hand. Now do with both the hands. Both are same. Both are same. No? Check it. See, don't tight your hand. Just lose it and you just take the impression. Both are same. So, keep it. Take the impression. Both the same. Both the same. Open your eyes. Okay, so this is the way we are going to give the presentation. So you need to interchange. Okay, first time you are going to give one. Okay, so the child way, see, this is the way you have to. Okay, if you keep like this, you can't. Okay, see, up and down. Okay, then you'll feel the weight. Okay, heavy hand, light. You will feel that, you will say no. Okay, again keep it back. Now you feel both are same. Okay, keep it, pair it. If you open your eyes, you can differentiate from the color. So better you need to blindfold. Yeah, thank you. Yes, got it. Only this we are going to teach the child, how to take the impression of weight and also pairing the same tablets, same weight tablets. Okay, then you can ask the child, because here again we have another one set of tablets, medium. Okay, the child can do the pairing. Okay, see possibilities. The child can do first and second box, second and third box, first and third box, first and third box, second, third. Okay, all those possibilities the child can work with it. Again, the child can take all the three and he can do the pairing activity. So you just interchange. Is it same? Is it same? Okay, you can feel it. Okay, so you just feel it. Both the hands. Can you differentiate? With a small variation, this is just a 10 grams of variation. 10 grams of variation the child should feel. Yes, later on you need to work, then only you'll understand. Okay, what is the direct aim of this presentation? To help the child become conscious of differences in heaviness of things, that is heavy and light, with the help of his baric sense. Indirect aim, to help the child to use the baric sense in his everyday life, to help the child become familiar with measurements of weight. Okay, okay, the other one thing what you can do, you can keep all the tablets. Activity, all the tablets. So I'm keeping only two sets. Okay, if you want, you can keep. Now the child is closing his eyes. We have all the tablets here. Okay, sorting. Heavy this side, light this side. Okay, just see. correct? One, yes. This does not belongs to this group. That's why. Three sets also. I'm just showing you the example. If you want all the three sets, keep it in a mixed form. Let the child sort out according to their weight. Become more conscious. His concentration level, again and again I'm telling, all these activities improves his concentration level. That is more important for nowadays children. They have to concentrate on one particular activity for a long time. That is not possible with the children. If you just see in front of the TV also, they'll be changing the channels. Why? They can't watch one program for a long time. First they'll put, yeah, Chota Bhim, next. They want to watch Mr. Bean. Next, another one channel. Why is that so? They doesn't have any patience to wait, or they doesn't have concentration so that they can watch one program for a long time. Maybe this is very attractive to the child, even though the child is not watching the same program. Have you seen children watching only one channel from morning till evening? They'll be changing. Each 5 minutes, they'll be changing. No? Because they doesn't have. Before, in our childhood days, we didn't have these many channels. Only Ramayana, Mahabharata, once in a week. Whole family used to sit and watch that. Do you remember? One regional movie they used to put on Sunday afternoon, I think. Sunday evening or afternoon. So maybe this week if it is Telugu movie, next week it is Tamil, then the Kannada, then some other language. Now we used to wait for that particular time to watch the movie. But nowadays, so for to make the child perfect, so you can use all these materials, right? So Barrick sense, I'm using only two sets. You can take all the three sets and you can do the sorting. Okay, you have to close your eyes and you have to do. You can't open your eyes to do this because you can differentiate with the colors. First pairing, okay, just to give one, because the child should be able to differentiate the differences in the weight. That's why it's a pairing. No, these two are not same. Again interchange. Yes, again interchange with this. These two are same? No, okay. Again take it back. Same. Same, yes. And then ask him to pair it. Got it? One is pairing. Then the pairing itself, you can do all the three box together, or these two combination, or these two combination. Understood, no? First and second. First and third. Second and third. Any doubts in Barrick tablets? You can feel this. Of course. Only first time when the child is taking the impression, you have to show how to take. She was confused because she was taking like this. Okay, stretch his hand. That's why I told, stretch your hand, then place one tablet here. Take the impression from one hand, then you give. Okay, see? Yeah, of course. Pairing you have to keep. Yes. Sorting, you can just explain the child. By this time the child is able to do. Again, another one advantage in Montessori method, the child will be watching this while other children are doing. This is not first experience to the child, but already has seen that. It is like you have seen how to prepare something. Okay, already you have seen, you know about that, but while doing first time, you will be more excited. Maybe you know, every day you will watch how to make pizza, how to make pizza. Okay, you'll Google it, you'll watch. But first time when you experiment that, you'll be having that excitement. Even for the child also, same thing. No, you observed, no, she only took little long time to say whether it is same or not. Even for the child also. Because that is her first time experience. If you give 1 kg and 2 kg, she can say, this is heavy, this is light. But with eyes closed, right? This is how the child learns, because he needs for his daily activities. In his daily life, he do this. Which is heavy, which is light. If you give an apple and one orange, which is heavy? Which is light? Right? Again, after this measurement, you can show the child how do we measure different things in different units. Okay, if you take liquid, we measure in liters. You can introduce all those things. This is 1 liter, half liter, or 1 kg. Okay, vegetables and all we purchase in kgs. Again, you can bring weighing machine. Okay, small weighing machine is available. Okay, small weighing machine you can bring. Okay, see a pink tar are there. Right? So pink tar, you can take a print of that, or else small small cubes you can draw. See first pink tar, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, in a sheet of paper. You can take a print and you can ask the child to weigh. See the weight of each cube and write how many grams. Digital, nowadays everything is available, no? Digital, you can see. Again, you can show different, even that weighing machine is there, no? They'll put that. 100 grams, sorry, 1000 grams, 500 grams, 250 grams, will get, no? That weighing, this one. So you can bring all those things. Okay, whatever possibilities regarding the measurements, you can show to the child. If you go to market, your mama will buy the vegetables. So how much she'll purchase? 1 kg of tomato. See, how do you measure 1 kg of tomato? Like this. Milk, how do you measure? Like this. No, liquid and whatever. All those things you can show to the different experiments. You can do it in your environment or in your classroom, wherever you want. Now, any doubts? No doubts? Now, given 8, here we have 7. Maybe that is grading material, you just see. No, barrack only. Just I wanted to tell you something else also. No? No. Okay. Yeah. So again, we'll get another one material, that is barrack sense grading material. Okay? Small boxes type will get it. Okay, all of same size. Okay, same color, same shape, but the weight is different. Okay, 15 grams to 15 grams variation or 10 grams variation. Okay, the first box starts with 25 grams. again 40, 55, 70, 85, 100, like that it varies in 15 grams. Okay, you can do grading. Okay, just see, I'm just tell you. Okay, just think. Okay, you just think these three are of same color and all those things. Okay, the child has to take the impression with eyes open only, because
same
it looks same, but only it differences in the weight. Okay, just see. I have arranged from light to heavy. That's it. We have one grading material also. Okay, you can do Varixen's grading. Pairing with these three boxes, grading means we'll get separate material which has same color, same size, but differences in their weight. First one starts maybe 25. If you want, you can prepare on your own. You can ask somebody, carpenter or someone, to do it for you. Okay, with different density, woods are available. Okay, they can polish with the same color. Okay, then you can do the grading. Again, name lessons, what you can teach?
Heavy,
light, and medium we can't. When you compare these three, one is heavy, one is light, one is medium. But the name lessons you can't teach medium. Medium happens when you have three things. Okay, when you have three, medium will be there. But always, you can, if you want, you can teach. Using these three, you can teach. But heavy, light, and comparative degrees of comparison. Superlative and comparative, you can also teach that using the grade material, grading material. No, grading material you have maybe 7 to 8 boxes or tablets like this. Okay, from light to heavy. Okay, the first one may be 10 grams, second one 20, third one 30, 40, 50, 60, like that. Whatever the difference you want, you can keep it equal differences. It's not like that one is 10, one is 15, one is 25. No. So each tablet should have the same differences. Okay, 15 if you start, 30, 45, 60, 75, 90, 105, 120. Okay, light to heavy. The child has to arrange from light to heavy or heavy to light. After that, you can give the degrees of comparison. Comparative and superlative. Yeah, any doubts in your Varixen's? No doubts? Or anybody will give the presentation of this? No? Okay, in the afternoon session. Or you want me to repeat this presentation once again? Please, I am only asking. I don't know whether you want it or not. You need? Yes. So, the presentation goes like this. Today shall we see how to another new material, or how to take the weight something. Okay, today shall we work with some new material? Yes. Take the child to the place of display, introduce the material, and bring only two boxes, only two boxes to the place of presentation. Okay, now you are going to teach the child how to take the impression of weight. Okay, stretch your hand, just think. child is doing. My hands are child's hand. Okay. Do like this. Let the child also do. You also do along with the child. Okay. Now the child knows how to take the impression. Okay, so shall we see what can we do with this? Okay, but you have to close your eyes, or else take blindfold and fold it. Okay, now both are same. The child says no, then both are same. Yes. Ask the child to keep it together. Okay, you can take some more also if you want. Okay. Both are same. Both are same. This is pairing activity. Okay, you're pairing for this. I'm pairing for this. Okay, I'm going to interchange only this. It's not like that you're interchanging both, because the child should have this impression in his mind, in his tactile sense, in his baric sense. Then the child is comparing with this. This is same, but he's comparing with this. Okay, got it? This is pairing. You can do for all the tablets. Okay, 8, it should be 8 because pairing, 4 pairs here. Yeah, you can bring the whole box. If this is the case, you can bring the whole box, because the other children, they can't work with only one set. Alright? See, if it is color tablets, we have a big box, third box. In that, what we used to do, we used to take a tray and bring only one set of color tablets, grading material. Here, if this is the case, if you want two sets, you can bring all the three, full box, but you take out only two. Because if you keep this one there, maybe you just think you'll bring it on the tray, but this is of no use to other children. They can't do anything with single box. Better you can bring whole box. If it is different boxes, you can bring first and third. Got it? This is pairing. Again, you can do with this only sorting. Keep everything in a mixed form. Now show to the child. See, I kept everything in a mixed form. Now you have to keep all the light things here, heavy things here. Light tablets here, heavy tablets here. Yes, the child is very happy, but with your eyes closed. Okay, the child takes the impression. Heavy tablets, he'll keep it here. Light tablets, he's going to place it here. Okay, if you want, for this activity, you can take the other one also. So, light, medium, heavy. Okay, then you give the name lessons. Okay, after that there is a grading material. Okay, so grading material, it has maybe all the same color, same size, but with different weight. So the child has to grade that. Any doubts? Cleared? Practice. Practice makes you perfect. Yeah, the next activity is tactile sense. Okay, what is tactile?
Touch.
What are the impressions we take? Rough and smooth. Okay, so rough and smooth. Okay, how to take the impression? Before taking any tactile impressions or tactile sense, you need to take a finger bath. You know finger bath? Even before presenting the sandpaper, okay, you need to take the finger bath. Okay, it is nothing but bring a bowl of water, hot water, okay, again cold water, mix hot and cold water till it is warm. Okay, then you need to put a finger in that, clean your tips of your finger, not the whole part of your hand, only the tips of your finger. Take a warm water if you are confused, not so cold, not so hot. Warm water, okay, in warm water you just dip your fingers, clean your tips of the fingers and take a napkin and wipe it, clean it. Got it? What is finger bath? We take a finger bath like this. Before doing any tracing activity, either it is sandpaper letter, sandpaper number, whatever it is. To take any impression, your fingertip should be clean. To take the impressions properly, okay? So now, how to take the impression just? Okay, here, you know already we have done the sandpaper letters, okay? So slowly, okay, just move your fingers first. Or else with two fingers or three fingers, it depends on the material, okay? All the three fingers at the same level, just start tracing from the top till the end, okay? Right? So after this, you can give the name lessons, rough and smooth. Okay, tactile sense, tactile, tactile sense. This is baric sense, this is tactile. Last class, taste sense, what is this? Gustatory. We have many more senses, but we teach in normal method only eyes to see, ears to listen. No, the child is getting the hands-on experience. Yeah, tactile sense, okay, tactile material, okay. After this you are going to give the name lessons, okay. How to give the name lessons? See, smooth, this is rough, this is rough, this is smooth. Can you give me smooth? Place rough here, place smooth here. Can you trace smooth tablet? Can you trace rough tablet? Give as many commands as possible. It's not like that, only two commands or three commands. What and all you can give, you go on giving the commands so that the child will be perfect. Whatever the name lessons, even in your traditional method, you can teach the names of things like this. Okay? Then, at the end, third period, this is rough, this is smooth. The child says the names, rough, smooth. Don't be confused. If you have any doubts, please clarify and then we'll move to the next step. Don't think first what ma'am thinks, again and again how to ask. Okay, forget all those things. Clarify all your doubts. Yeah? Again. Tactile material. Tactile. No, I'll just tell you that. This is tactile tablets. What we did now, it's a tactile tablets. Just yeah. Next we have touch tablets. Over now, tactile over, now it's a touch tablets. Okay, I'll show you this. So here, touch tablets. Don't be confused with the touch tablets. We have touch tablets. If you take rough, we have two sets. Okay. See, one set, it is from rough to roughest. Can you see? Rough to roughest. This is grading material. If you have one set, using one set, you have five tablets. This is called touch tablets. Okay, rough material, one set, we have five tablets from rough to roughest, five intensities of roughness. Less rough to more rough, rough to roughest, whatever you call. Five intensities, only one set. What can we do?
Grading.
If we have the same two sets,
pairing.
Same thing, same five tablets, we have another one set. So when we use these two sets, this is for pairing. Two sets for pairing, one set for grading. Five intensities of roughness. Got it? Yeah. Both same material, two sets. Word map. Okay, that is like a puzzle. Okay. So, puzzle is available, okay? I've seen children or else I download some videos to show you. Maybe in the next class we'll arrange. The child can learn all the names of the states. Only puzzle, okay, just Karnataka map, all the districts, if you take India map, all the states according to their sheet, they'll make it as a puzzle. See, this is Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, only 3, 3, 4, 4 you teach as a name lesson. Okay, then where is Karnataka? Keep Karnataka here, just with the shape, with the color, they'll identify everything. So after that you can teach names of oceans, names of continents, where is our India, where do we live. Simply we teach India is our country, Karnataka is our state. Now instead of that, through the puzzle you can teach. This is maybe after 5. Yes, obviously we have seen in Montessori observed children, we have seen children telling all the names of states, Indian states, all the district names of Karnataka nicely. This is Bangalore, this is Mandya, this is this, this is that, this is Mysore, this is Tumkur. The child is able to say, because every day he'll do the activity again according to the shape we have with the knob. They'll just see, they'll keep that. Every day if you practice, now few videos I want to show you. I'll download few videos. By next class, it will be, no, I'll just see. Before our Montessori session ends, we'll watch few videos. Now that time you'll understand how children works. Pinter, just 9 month old child works with Pinter. Yes, of course this is, because you're not senior. No, how ma'am? You know, maybe now also you're thinking, why ma'am is telling so many things? Can we give this to small children? Of course, yes. 100%. We have seen. If you go and visit any pure Montessori school, you can see, or else go to Google. Just give children working with this. You'll get many videos. You can see how children works in Montessori method. You'll be surprised after seeing. Right? So, you want to finish? Yeah? Question patterns you had asked Sadaf ma'am. So we have another one material in sensorial, very interesting material that we are going to do it in the afternoon session. Right, very interesting material we have. Okay, that we'll do it in the afternoon session. So we'll take a break. Yes, it's time to take a break. We'll take a break. We'll meet after half an hour. Yeah, good afternoon. So almost we have completed our sensorial. Right? Any doubts? Whatever we have done till now. Because this is the 11th class and almost we have come to an end. Okay, any doubts regarding your sensorial? No? So, whenever you are coming, please do practice. Okay? So, any doubts, whatever we have done, everything you just make a note of it. Okay, make a list. Okay, the last session. Okay, only will clear the doubts and everyone wants to give presentation. Yeah, no doubts. So, shall we start with a new presentation? Yes, in sensorial, decanomial square. Decanomial square. DECONOMIAL, decanomial square. Yeah, this is the material. okay, for your decoromial squares. So here we have 10 compartments. We have 10 compartments. Right, the first one is small square red. Okay, in 10 compartments you just write down the colors. First one is red, green, first is red, green, second is green, pink, fourth yellow, fifth is light blue, purple, white, brown. After white, it's brown, dark blue, the last one is orange. Yeah, once again, the first one is red, green, pink, yellow, blue, purple, white, brown, dark blue, orange. Color may vary sometimes, right? But see, according to the sizes. Got it? Yes. Invitation. Take the child to the place of display, introduce the material, okay, or show the material. Do you like to work with this material? Okay, invitation, you can take the child to the place of display and you can show the material and you can give. Today shall we see how to work with this material? Yes, the child says yes, then introduce the material. This is decanomial square, okay. So how to carry? Now the child knows because already is carrying all the materials. Okay. So before that, ask him to unroll a work mat at the place of presentation. Okay. Now, just see how to give the presentation. Indicating to the first box. Okay, can you take out this square? It's a small square. Okay, you just place it at the top left corner. Top left corner. Right? Then ask the child to take out the squares from the second compartment, because here we have three. Okay, in the second we have three. Okay, one is square. Okay, only one we have a square. So ask the child or show the child how to place it diagonally to the first one. Can you see? You have to place it like this. Okay, just think, this is first one, like this.
Only one square.
Green, only one square. You saw how to place? Okay, so first red is here. Just show him how to place. Okay, can you all see? So here we have a gap. Can you see the gap? Here and here. Now ask the child to fill that gap with the remaining shapes. This is not a square, this is a rectangle. Okay, so can you fill this area with the other green color shapes or whatever? Okay, now the child has to place it properly to fill that gap. Right? Next, ask the child to take the squares from the third compartment. Again, here also we have one exact square. Okay, ask him to place it in the same way as he did. Okay, again ask him to fill this area with the remaining squares. So this is not exactly square, triangle, but even rectangle also belongs to square family, right? So ask him to fill this gap. Okay, now next, ask him to take out the squares from the fourth compartment. Okay, ask him to take the square. Ask him to fill the gap. You're not able to see? You can come. So ask him to fill this gap with the remaining squares. Again, while filling the gap, you can see here the sizes. See? Now ask him to take the squares from the next compartment. Right? In this, ask him to pick squares. square. Okay, this place, ask him to to fill this gap. Squares. No, this is not a proper square. See? Yeah. No. Yeah, it's not a square. Okay. Just ask him to fill that place. Fill the square. Okay, again ask him to take out the squares from the next compartment. That's why one by one we have to take it out. Okay, now ask the child to take the square from here. See? Had a doubt, no? See, this is not a square, okay? In the same way, right? See, it's a weak square. Okay, this is how we are going to build the decanomial square. Okay, see. Look at here. At every step, color changes. But see, red is a square. Along with red, if you take green, red and green, it's a square. Again, if you take this, it's a square. Again, red to yellow, it's a square. Again, start from red to blue, it's a square. Okay? So that it's a big square. Okay, what is the direct aim? To help the child to utilize his consciousness with regard to color, shape and dimensions to build the decanomial square. To help indirect aim, to help the child prepare himself for the study of higher arithmetic and geometry and algebra, to help the child retain his motor coordination. Okay, so another one thing I'll tell you. Okay, you can show him so many, see, superimposed figures. Superimposed figures. We say, see, 1 square, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can give all these squares to him. You can ask him to build or keep one above the other. Again, you can take some rectangles are also available here. Okay, you can build. You know, this is one exercise, superimposed figures Again, we have another material, also superimposed figures, circles, all the rectangles, one above the other, they'll keep, okay, with different colors. Understood, no? It's just building the squares, okay? Each time when you build the square, red color, it's a square. Then when you put all the three greens, red and green, it makes a square. Again, green, pink, yellow. Only those three also makes a square. Each time when you add one color, it's a square. Okay? This is one activity. Okay? Next one, can you just dismantle? Will you help me? Superimposed figures. They should come here. See, according to the size, you have to keep the. You white, let it be here. Wait. Got it now to arrange the decalomial square? The other one is superimposed figure, one activity you can do along with this. Okay, the next exercise, the next day, okay, you can ask the child to bring the decanomial square box. Ask him to take out any one of the colors. Okay. For example, you just think he has taken out white color, okay? So, this is the square, place it. Now ask him, okay, can you do as many as squares possible with the other squares, okay? This is the square. So, he has to make squares using the remaining tablets or remaining squares, okay? See? Now it's a square, right? So this is remaining. So you can make other four same squares, or else you can keep it. see, I made 4 squares. Okay, again with the other box. We have some more, sorry. So using all the squares, totally we can make 6. One is square, so on top of that, yes, even superimposed figure as we did, even you can do with the rectangle also. You can just see the sizes. You can place on rectangles also and the squares also. This we are going to give before the constructive triangles. Okay, before the constructive triangles, after trinomial cube, because already the child knows, is worked sufficiently regarding the shape, color and size. So we are giving as many activities as possible for the child. It is really very challenging for the child. It's a big square. Okay, each time when he builds, he'll see that size. Even see, okay, this is a square, just he has to see the size, everything to fill that place. Did you observe? So every time it used to coincide. Coincidence used to happen, see, when diagonally it should meet. Right, any doubts? Decanomial square, it is not there in your textbook. This is another sensorial activity. So after this, I want you people to come here 2-2. Okay, you need to give a presentation. Right? Today I want to see how you are giving the presentations. Yeah? Yeah, we'll do it. We have a time. Yeah, any doubts? Decanomial square? No. No, nothing. Just you bring this material, okay. First you bring this material, show him the first compartment, ask him to take out this red square, okay. Yeah, here we have only one square, okay, red. So ask him to place it at the left top corner. Don't tell the child, place it in the left top corner, you just tell him to place it here. The child will not understand what is left, top, corner and all. Okay, just place it here. Again, ask him to take out the squares in the second compartment. As he'll take it out, okay, ask him to take out the square from here. Where's the square here? The child shows this. Again, show him how to place it diagonally. Okay. See, we have a place here and here. Can you fill that place with this? No? That's why I told, whenever you are giving the presentation, it depends on you and the child, how the child understands. Okay, can you fill this gap with this? Okay, the child takes. See, beginning you have to help the child. Right? It's not like that only you are giving the commands and child is doing. See, now also it is looking square. Now it's a square. Single red, it is also a square. When you fill that with, when you cover that gap, okay, then it becomes a square. Okay, again ask him to take out the squares of third compartment. Where is the square? So square, the child shows the square. So ask him to place it. Okay, how to place, you know, no? Yes. By this time the child has understood. Yes, I have to fill that gap. Now ask him to fill the gap. So he can't fill with this. See, it's not matching. The lines are not together. So when he keeps, it looks like a single line. Okay. Ask him to cover. See, now also it is looking like a square. Okay. In the same manner, you have to sit along with the child till he completes all the colors. The child enjoys doing that. Yes, ask him to take next one, square. Okay, then if the child is doing perfectly, you can ask the, tell the child, so you complete with all the colors and then call me. Okay, then one day you can ask the child to take out only the squares. Okay, superimposed. See, it's very attractive with different colors. Okay, you can arrange from small square to large square or rectangle or take any. If it, see, he has to work with all the compartments. See, just now I showed with the white color. Next time you take him to take orange. Orange is little bigger one, so you can make many squares. Okay, every time you have to give. This is just, you can think, 4, 4.5 year old child. After trinomial cube. Okay, now he knows the color. We have introduced all the colors, shapes and sizes. Right? Any doubts? Once you work, then only you understand, ma. Okay. So after this, I'll see how you people will give the presentations. No doubts? Yeah, by this we are going to end our sensorial. Right? So, just go home, read your textbook. Any doubts, please make a list. Okay, so then we'll clarify your doubts in the next class. Again, practice how to give the presentation, not to, you're just seeing the material. Yes, this is how we work, just you're keeping it back, but you're not practicing the way you have to practice. No doubts? Okay. So, yeah, by this we are ending our sensorial. Okay, morning I've explained you the other activities where you can only prepare your own materials. Right, almost we have covered everything in sensorial. So now, arithmetic, the last material in arithmetic. Yeah, can you just pass me your textbook? Yeah, just those who are having the textbooks, just open. confusing. Yeah, this is called dot game. You have a board. Okay, you have a board here. It is called dot game. Dot game. This we are using to do addition, long addition. Okay, long addition. Dot game. We call this as a dot game. Dot game. Dot board. It's better I'll draw it on the board. Okay, I'll show this also. Can you see? Yes. Okay. Now okay, now you have to write a problem. Okay, just I'll write it here for your reference. Okay, this is your problem. So I am going to write it here on the board. Can you see the square grids here? Can you see this? This last one is for the answer. Okay, now I am going to write it here. Just whatever the problem I've written on the board, the same thing I've written here. Right? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Right? Don't be confused. Okay. Now, which are the ones here? See, how do we add this? 2, 5, 3, or else? Okay, the first number, ones. Okay, so how many ones?
Two.
How many ones here?
Two
ones. So here you have to put two dots. Next. Okay. Sorry. Strike out. Next, how many ones?
Five
ones. So what I'll do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You practice, each and every one has to practice with the board. Then only you'll get that. Strike out this five. Over, no? Strike out. Here also. Next, how many ones? One, two, three. Yes, yes, yes. Wait. Don't worry. Yes. Now, I have got how many ones?
10 ones.
10 ones means what?
One ten.
Strike it out. Pass the 2, 1 10. Didn't get? That's why I told, don't write afterwards. I'll give you enough time to write and practice. See, first we had 2 ones. Put it 2 here. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 3. 1, 2, 3. Altogether it is?
10.
So I put 10 dots here. 10 grids are there. 10 boxes are there. We have put 10. So 10 ones is equal to? 110. So I am just striking out 10 ones. I am shifting that to here. 1. See here. 2 plus 5. 7. 7 plus 3. 10. 0 here. 1 goes to 10th place. Correct? In the same manner, I am just striking out all the ones. I am just putting, it's a 1. 1, 10. So 1 dot here. Understood? No? Yes. Next, we'll come to tens. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then, correct? Yes. 1, 2. Then, 1, 2, 3. So what I'll do now? Strike out. How many tens?
10
tens equals to?
100.
See? 5, 7, 10 plus 1 here. 100. Got it?
Yes.
Next, we'll come to?
100.
Hundreds. So, how many?
6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next, we'll just strike out everything. 3. 1, 2, 3. Next, 1. So what I have to do now? Correct. 6, 7, 10, 11. 1 year. 1 year. Now it comes to 1,000. Yeah. How many thousands?
2.
I'll put 2 here. Next?
9.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then?
6.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Then what I have to do now? Strike out. 10 thousands. 10 thousands is equal to?
1.
10,000. No? So pass it. 10 hundreds equal to 1,000. 10 thousands. I am not telling. Thousands. 10 thousands equals to? 10,000. Okay? Just pass that. Now you write. How many here? How many here?
1.
How many here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How many here? 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 Then write the answers here. You see? 3. 12, 18. Correct? Interesting? You can, but how many chart paper? This board is available. Again, the child wipe it. See, if you give your worksheet, one worksheet for one problem. This board will be there. Okay, even child, if he does 2-3 problems in a day, okay, this is the last one. The child who is around 5 years, we are going to give this So let him do every day. See, he is getting that concept of addition, how to transfer. Right? So this is called dot game. You can wipe it out. If you have a sponge, nicely you can wipe it out. You should keep two color pens to write one and to strike out. Okay? So each time when the child puts the dots, maybe three is going to strike out this. So that the child is not getting confused. Already it's done. Okay, nice, no? Yes. So nothing. See, here you can make a grid like this to write the problems. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands. So 10 by 10. 10 into 10. 10 rows and columns. 10 into 10. 10 rows and 10 columns. Are you all writing it? No? Do you want me to do another problem?
Yes,
you have to ask no. Yes, if I ask, they'll say yes, ma'am. Yeah, anybody will come and do it? Yeah, that's better. First, as I did, somebody hold it and somebody write on the board, somebody do it on this board. Yes, erase that, write another one problem. You take this, yeah, first. So you can do, you can take 4, 5. No, you come here. You just stand here. Hold it like this, show to the camera. Hold it like this. Yeah. Only Montessori manufacturer, material manufacturers. So these things, whatever the Montessori materials, you won't get it anywhere outside. Give another presentation also. No, chair. No, no, afterwards. Presentation I have to give. Little louder. Do it.
First of all, you have to take the ones position.
Any color.
First one position is one. Here one. First of all, we have to make a dot here. Here one is there, so only one dot here. Now we have to strike it out. This one. Now we have to take the second one. This is the 4-1 position. You have to mark 4 ones here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Strike it out. Next one is 6. 6 ones here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now strike it.
Say here.
Now here 10 positions are over. 10 ones are there. 10 ones means 1 10. Now
you want to take
them? You have to strike it out. Keep one dot in 10th position. Okay. Now we have to take this one 10th position. This is 2. Right. Then 2 tens here. Open. 2 dots here. 1, 2. Now 7. 7 dots here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Again 2. 2 dots here. 1, 2. Now, here 10 tens are there. 10 tens means 100. One dot here in 100 position. Now, you have to take 4. This one, 100 position. This is a 4. 4 dots we have to give here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next is 6. 6 dots here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now 5. 5 dots here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we completed this one. 10 hundreds means 1000. Now take the next position, 1000 position. First one is 5. 5 dots here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next is 3. 3 dots here. 1, 2, 3.
Board is also
next
dull.
Is 2. 2 dots here. It's over. Now 10,000 means 1 10,000.
This is how I wanted.
That's right.
Those who are watching, no? They can see.
How many 10,000 are here?
One.
How many thousands are here?
One.
How many hundreds are here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many tens are here?
2.
How many ones are here?
1.
So the answer is?
Understood? Right? This is how we are going to do the addition. As I told in the previous classes, addition means not only with the beads, not only with the boards, we have more materials like this type of material where the child sufficiently works with it. It's not like that simply addition, right? Something on the board, okay, something in the mind, something in the hand, add it. No, we have enough materials only for addition. Okay, addition is more important. This is the age where the child learns more of addition. At least if he gets all other concepts also we are teaching. Along with this, we are having so many other materials and so many other exercises where the child gets the concept right? You will be wondering because you are doing, it's okay. But even the 5-year-old child can able to do long addition, long multiplication, everything using these manipulatives. See, here how many grids are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You can take a long addition. Now, you'll come to know, yes, how to shift. Why we are shifting? Which number we have to shift? Okay, children, even in class 2 and 3, they're confused. Okay, if they're adding 5 plus 6, it's 11. Okay, now leave it, 11. Maybe if it is 12, which number he has to shift? Either 1 or 2. Sometimes they'll shift 2. Okay, blindly they are learning. Why we are shifting? So if you put the dots, yes. 2 is your, that 110 or whatever will shift. Got it? So you can give a long addition for the child. As she told, prepared problems you can give. Okay, like this. Just ask him to write it on the board and do it and write the answers. Worksheet using dot game. You can't prepare this for your reference. You can prepare and keep it, but you can't give for all the children. Once you can give, that's it, no? But this board will help the child. Obviously, get that concept of shifting to the next hierarchy. Yeah, any doubts? Now, any doubts regarding your addition board, subtraction, multiplication, and division, and dot game? Yeah? This is for addition. Even you can try subtraction also with this. Can you try subtraction with this? How to do subtraction? What you have to do for subtraction? Yeah, what you have to do, tell me. Yeah, first you need to take any number. Okay, problem. Just write down. First, what you have to do? For the first number, you have to put the dots. Put the dots. 8 ones, 3 tens, 6 hundreds, and 2 thousands. Then strike out these numbers. Whatever the answer remaining, you can write. If it is borrowing, propose any problem with borrowing. Borrowing. Yeah. 20. Very good. Small problem. Good. 25 minus 18. Okay. So now 25 ones and tens. So ones, how many?
5.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tens?
2.
1, 2. Now, how many we have to minus?
8.
8 ones and 1 ten. So, do we have 8 ones here?
No.
Now, what we have to do now?
1
to borrow. So, I'll cancel 1 here, or if it is dot, I'll cancel 1 10 here. I'll bring how many?
10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In the term, I have to give?
8.
So I've given 8. Okay, again, how many I have to give?
1.
How many I have to give?
1. One we
have. How many tens we have to give?
One tens.
So what is the remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Correct? Got it? I didn't get it. You didn't get. Oh God. Yeah, you propose one problem with the borrowing. Small problem like this. Addition understood, no?
Yes.
Yes. Subtraction, propose any problem like this with borrowing fast. 20? 36 minus 7. 36 minus, yeah. Now, stop writing and tell me how many ones?
Six.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many tens? 1, 2, 3. Okay. So, now, in 36, in 6 ones, how many ones have to take it out?
7 ones.
Do I have 7 ones here?
No.
We are having 7 ones?
No.
No, what we have to do now? See, now what we'll do? We'll take 1 10 from here. It becomes 16. So, then it becomes 2. It becomes 16. So, here I'm taking out this 1 10 from here. I'm shifting this side. When I'm shifting, it becomes 10 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now how many have to take it out? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'll just cross 7. How many remaining? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 is the answer. Again, here it is 2. 29 is the answer. See, the main what we think is our child is not capable. Our children are not capable. So we'll leave it. But if you see in Montessori method, children, they'll do all these things nicely. It's very easy method. They'll get the concept of addition, subtraction. Now, maybe now it is, we feel how to give the presentation. Once you start giving the presentation from the age of 2 and a half till 6 years, it goes like this. As I told in the morning, children are able to say all the names of states, all the countries' names, continents, oceans. Only thing they have to see, just if simply says India, India. What is India? The child doesn't know what is India. But if we ask which is our country, they are able to say, India is my country. What is India? Where is India? Where are we? What is earth? In third standard, they learn, earth is made up of land and water. Social. But here you are teaching the concept through the material. You have a globe. You can see this is our earth. Earth is made up of land and water. We are on the land. Okay, again, painted globe. You can show. See, this is land. Here we have a land. So this is America. This is India. If you want to go to America, how to go? Do we have the roadways? No. All those things you can explain to them. That's why we go through air. Aeroplane. We don't have a bus, we don't have a road to go. Or else see, from here to Mysore, we have a road. Okay, to Sri Lanka, do we have a road? No, we have to go by water or by air. All those things you have to explain. These are the real facts. Instead of telling that crowd, that, this, all the stories. Why can't you say these stories? Why can't you bring these materials, readily available materials, show to the children and explain them? Definitely they'll understand. Don't you think that child will, your child will not understand if you teach globe and all? Yes, obviously they'll understand. No, because you know, we are not experimenting. So we doesn't know. We doesn't know our capacity. We didn't know our capacity. That's why till now we were at home. After marriage, we were at home. So please, okay, don't think the child is not able to. Few are slow learners, but if you give hands-on experience, the child definitely will learn everything. That's why sensorial, so many materials. Why, ma'am, decanomial square? We need it. Don't think the child sits for a long time, improves his concentration level. Yeah, no doubts? Yeah.
100 minus 59.
100 minus 59. Oh, you are going for the complicated one. Do we teach all these things to the children? We'll try, even I have not tried till now. That's why I told, we'll get children of all varieties of children. Few, whatever we say, they'll accept. They doesn't question. Few are like this, right? As a teacher, you should be ready for everything. Yeah? So 100 minus 59. Yeah. Ones?
No ones.
Tens?
No,
hundreds?
100.
So? 59. In ones we have to give?
Nine.
Nine we have to give. Okay, here we doesn't have? Nine. Okay, so what I'll do here? How many hundreds we have here? Here also in tens I don't have anything. I don't have anything to give.
100.
Hundreds is there. Directly I can't take this hundreds to ones. So what I'll do and cancel this 100, I'll take 10 tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again here I don't have. Again I have to take. Oh, so I'll cancel 1, I'll take 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. How many I have to give?
9.
So I'll give 9. Again, here how many I have to give?
Five.
What is the remaining here?
One.
What is the remaining here? Got it, 41? You can teach to the children also the same way. Got it, no?
Yes.
100. Okay. In ones, zero, no number. Tens also, zero, no number. In hundreds, we have only 100. So I want to give 9, but I don't have anything. But here, I don't have, my grandfather is having. I can't take directly from my grandfather, so I'll shift that to my father. That is the case. Okay. Now this 100 becomes 10 tens. Again, I have to take from tens. So 1 10, I'll stack it out. That shifted here as 10 ones. In 10 ones, I'm giving 9. In 10, again here we have no. So I'll give, the answer is 41. Got it? So directly you can't take. That's why. When we shift, okay. The procedure is, this here we are shifting. Okay. Again from this we are taking 9. But directly we are teaching to the children. But this is the procedure. In 100, so you are taking directly here, it becomes 10, it becomes 9. How it is becoming? The child doesn't know how it is becoming. Directly we are shifting so that the 0 becomes 9. How it becomes 9? No, when you are shifting this 100, okay, 90 we are giving here. Only 10 we are taking here. That concept child has to understand. Directly when you do these sums, child will not understand that concept. Simply blind way of doing. No, got it? Got solutions for all your problems? Yeah? So using dot game you can do addition and subtraction.
Multiplication also you can.
You try it out and tell me in the next class. Yeah? Repetition of addition, the same numbers you are going to take how many times you want. Dots. You are going to shift. That's it. Yeah, chair. Yeah. No doubts? Dot game? No. Can anybody help me to shift this? So presentations regarding the chair, how many are done with the chair? Do you remember? July. Go back to July. Sitting on the chair. Before, yeah, first we thought sitting on the chair, getting up from the chair, how to hold and carry, how to keep it down. Okay, again sitting on the chair which is near to the table, which is close to the table, that also you can teach. Okay, now how to sit on the chair. Okay, now I'm not going to say anything, right? Now this you can give for a group of children. It's not an individual presentation, it's a group presentation. Okay, shall we see how to sit on a chair? This is how we sit on a chair. Now, how to get up? Okay. This is how we get up from a chair. Did I move the chair? Did I make any noise? Right? If you are having a handle, okay, here we doesn't have a handle, so I was holding a base of the chair, a seat of the chair. If you have a handle, you can hold the handle instead of seat. Okay, so how to hold, lift and keep it down. Now today shall we see how to hold and lift a chair? Okay, shall we see how to keep the chair down? Okay. This is how we keep the chair down. Yeah, any other doubts? So we need to give some more EPL presentations. Okay, so in the next class, whatever the remaining in language and EPL, okay, we'll finish it off. So any doubts, again and again and again I'm telling, any doubts in giving the presentations or regarding any areas, EPL, sensorial, arithmetic, language, Okay, please make a list, clarify, and please learn to give the presentations. Right? Now, somebody should come and give this presentation. Start from invitation. You take any child. If you want, you can take a child.
Today, let's see how to sit on a chair. Okay. Just watch what I'm doing, okay?
Yeah, correct. What did you observe? Come on, you have to say, you have to give feedback. Okay, you leave it, what she told, what she didn't and all those things. The way she did. Correct? She was not at all confident. Okay, see, while sitting, her body was not stiff. Like somehow, I'll show, no, something. It was like that. Okay, when you're showing, when you're presenting something, how your presentation should be. No, see, the same thing, I'll do it once again. So morning itself, I told, before giving any presentations, your materials, your manipulators should be ready. It was not ready. So what she did? She gave invitation, then she shifted a chair. All these things makes a lot, matters a lot. Right? See, sitting on a chair, it's very easy. Right? See? You're standing straight. Okay, you are shifting yourself, okay, you are bending, you are holding, slowly you are sitting yourself on the chair. This is the way we sit on a chair. Shall we see how to get up from a chair? Okay. This is the way we get up from a chair. Did I make any noise? Did I move the chair? Do you want to do it? Do it. Come on, try.
Shall I give the invitation?
Yes, start.
Shall you see how to sit on a chair today?
This is how we are going to sit on a chair. Now, let's see how to get up. Yeah. Tell me, what did you observe? Huh? I think you're not observing. Watch it, tell me.
In the chair after she bent it. First, you have to bend and then have to hold it.
sitting, while sitting. Okay. Then?
Our movements were not clear.
That's what I told you, your movements. Take a time. See, while you're sitting, okay, I sat. You're very hurry. You're keeping like this, no? See, how I'm doing? First you take out, pause for a while, then you remove your other hand. Okay? Even while getting up, see, first you have to insert. So what I observed, simply she was touching. She was not holding it. Okay? Hold it firmly so that the chair doesn't move. Okay? Rise yourself and then release your hands. Stand straight. Okay? Make your dress proper. You're showing the child. Okay? Then you shift yourself to the side. No? Your movement should be very much clear. Yes? Nothing is easy. Even how to keep the glass down. That also you need to practice. Again, next year you are going to suffer. Again, that time you have to see everything, you will get it in a net. I'm not telling you about that. Notes. I'm not worried. PSTTA, we are worried. Again, our concern, our students has to learn the proper way of Montessori method. Okay. So, please, a request from our side. Okay. Because nowadays, the real fact is, all the Montessori houses of children, they are closing because they are not getting quality teachers. Nobody is following proper Montessori method. Nobody is valuing it. Somebody, okay, we have to do, we are doing. We have the materials, yes. Nobody is following. Why are we using this material? What is the concept behind that? How to convince the parents? No, nobody is bothered. Nowadays teachers also, training. So don't go to that level, please learn. Right? Montessori, they are a good method of teaching if you follow in a correct way. Any doubts? Start practicing, please. Learn to give the presentation, my humble request. Beginning from the preparation, invitation, again introducing the child, statement, presentation, last statement, winding up, everything. Right? So this is, by this we are going to end our session. Any doubts? Next class. Thank you.